We have taken into account many processes like osmosis, plasmolysis, deplasmolysis, and we have discussed about various pressures and potentials. Now, why have we discussed all this? In order to understand the importance of water. Now, you study the importance of water in chemistry as well. You study the importance of water in biology as well. Now, when we study in the multicellularity in terms of plants, we are dealing with water as the universal solvent. Living systems have abundant water inside them, and when we talk about plants, the water being universal solvent, it has many activities which it carries inside the plants. So the basic properties of water, like water potential, the osmotic potential, the solution that it forms, and because of that the solute potential that is being generated, it is responsible for maintaining the turgidity of the cells. So we see that water is responsible for maintaining the physiological plant cell physiologically intact, okay, because the cell sap, which is lots of water dissolved with the solutes, is responsible for carrying out all the metabolic activities which are present inside the plant cell. So it keeps the cells, it keeps the plant cell physiologically intact because it is the main constituent of the cell sap. Talking about the external conditions, this is about the physiological aspect of the water. There is another physical aspect of the water which is responsible for the process of transpiration. Now, as we move further in understanding of this chapter, we are going to see that this process of transpiration is very, very important for carrying out the movement of water inside the plant, the transport of water, the absorption of water is done for carrying out the process of transpiration. So, water plays an important role in the process of transpiration. It is water which is responsible for carrying out the transpiration, and through this process of transpiration, the water that is being carried to the leaves from the roots, the rest of the processes are taking place. Okay, then the third thing is that osmotically this water plays an important role. Because of osmosis by different cells, there are phenomena like root pressure, okay, the movement of munch, or you can say these phenomena we are going to study later on, but because of the osmosis where water is the universal solvent, the cells are active and they carry out the process of osmosis, due to which the root pressure theory, which is responsible greatly for absorption of water from the soil, it is because of the osmosis which is carrying out. And do remember, the driving force behind the osmosis is water itself. And apart from this, water maintains the cells turgid, due to which the leaves are having their shapes maintained and they are facing the sun, because of which the photosynthesis is taking place. The plants do not undergo wilting. So there is lots and lots of importance of water. This is just a brief idea that we have studied about the terms till now. It was primarily dealing with the water, though we were using the term solvent again and again. Do keep in mind, in terms of plant cells, that solvent is water only. Secondly, we have dealt with the various things like cell sap, and we are going to deal with rest of the processes where water plays the crucial role, okay, because it is responsible for maintaining the turgidity in the cells, it is responsible for making the cell sap inside the plant cell, and it is responsible for carrying out the activity of transpiration, where the plants are going to get rid, this is a completely physical process, where the plants are able to get rid of the water. Because of this transpiration, there is absorption which is taking place, and because of the absorption which is taking place, the plant cells are able to maintain whatever water requirement they need. So we have lots and lots of importance of water. Few of them have been studied prior to this lesson, and after this lesson we are going to see the further importance. All the topics would be importance of water only, because this topic, the entire topic that we are studying, and various small lessons that we have dedicated to understanding the plants processes is basically the relation of plant cell with water. That is why we call it plant water relationships. And that relation with water of the plant cell plays an important role in the transport of solutes within the plant, okay? And transport plays an important system because as in our body, we have the vascular system. From one place to another, something has to be moved so that all the living cells, they need whatever they require, okay? And they get whatever they require. So in the same way, the water is, the water which acts as solvent and which is the important constituent of the cell, itself plays a very, very important role in the transport of the solutes from one place to another. So that is the basic importance of water. We are going to talk about the transport of water that takes place, whether it is active or passive, in the next lesson.